All right, today we're going to be covering IR heat lamps and IR curing. IR stands for infrared, and it's a curing technology that's very fast and efficient, especially compared to standard convection curing. It's often used for spot repair curing with auto body fillers or for repair curing on auto body panels, as well as in powder curing and a variety of curing applications. It can be used in a format as small as a handheld lamp, like you'll see here, all the way up to a full IR curing oven. Before we dive in, we'll go over a little bit about the basics of what IR curing is and how it works. So IR curing uses wavelengths of IR energy to create surface heat from the product outward, which allows for the coating or powder coating to cure from the inside toward the surface. It creates a very efficient full thickness cure in a short amount of time. There are various wavelengths of IR energy that are used to create a cure. For paint and powder coat curing, they're usually short and medium wavelengths. Long wavelength energy isn't typically used because of the heat that it creates isn't very efficient or effective for curing paint and powder. So the difference primarily between a short and medium wavelength IR wave is that a short wave is very intense and is used for smaller surfaces because it tends to create a lot more heat in a short period of time, whereas a medium length tends to be a little more dispersed and is used for a wider flat area in general that you want to cure, say a whole car panel or a large flat surface. One of the limitations about IR before you consider it is that it doesn't do well curing what it can't see. So the wave that it generates needs to be able to visibly light up the surface of the product that you're painting, curing, so that you get a cure. So if you have a product with a lot of angles and corners, something like that, it may or may not be a very good, it would not always be a good solution to use as a single source to cure because the heat won't be able to hit into the corner areas and other aspects of the part. However, for a wide flat part like this one here, it's a very ideal solution. It's going to cure fast and efficient. In fact, this middle part here, this is a powder coat that we have on here. This was cured with the lamp, and we did that in about 3 to 4 minutes. And we'll go ahead and demo a little more of the curing process here. Because this is a wide flat surface, this would be well suited for a medium shortwave, medium primary with some shortwave IR lamp. So we'll go ahead and fire up the lamp, show you that how that works. Now, when we're using an IR lamp, what we're gonna do, you can see here, this is uncured powder. So you see there, it's uncured. I have about a mil or two of powder on there, and I'm simply going to hold the heat lamp over the product surface until a cure begins to happen. A lot of ways that you can impact the speed of cure, there's variations in how powerful the lamp itself is, how much energy output it's gonna give you. How close the lamp will be to the product will also impact the heating speed and efficiency. As well, one of the benefits though will be, in general, the air environment doesn't significantly change how fast the cure happens. So if your shop is a cold shop, you don't have air, ambient air or heated air that's available in the shop, and it's a cooler winter month, and you're trying to cure a auto body panel or even some powder coating part, IR is going to give you fast, effective cure without the time delay required while you're trying to heat up an oven or the whole shop. So we'll hold it here for a while. You'll see it's going to do its work as we go along here. What I can do while I am heating it is I can use an infrared or a temperature thermometer, like you can use for any standard HVAC IR thermometer. And then we can check the surface temp. And what we're gonna look for, since it's heating from the inside out, that surface is gonna be hot. The lamp itself doesn't create significant amounts of heat. I can put my hand under it without any significant burn or feeling of the heat, but the surface is very hot. If you look right now, the surface is about 400 degrees. And that's actually about what the curing point is for most powders, is around 4 to 450 degrees. So we'd be holding that lamp there until we got enough heat there to cure it. And what you'll see is, At this point, that powder coating has been pretty much cured. That's with a Revo handheld unit. Whether you're using a handheld or you're using a panel that's fixed on a rack, the principle will be the same. It's just about the degree of coverage. Obviously, a larger light would cover more area, as well as the positioning of the light relative to the part and the part it's designed for. So if this was on a stand, it would use more medium wavelength to help cure from a little bit longer distance, as well as cure a larger surface. So you see here on the time, it took about a couple minutes to bring that powder up to temp. And then just to show you, since this part hasn't been touched by the IR heat, there's no cure there. However, the surface over there is still very hot, and the surface over here is not. So that's IR curing, and that's a Revo handheld. You can get these from a handheld to a panel. But as you see, IR gives you a lot of curing efficiency, and it can be used on a variety of substrates as well because it's curing from the inside out. So here we're using it on a metal panel. We also can use that on like composite or semi-plastic material. It's a very flexible curing technology that's efficient and takes significantly less time and doesn't depend on full heating of your shop or anything like that. So it's a very good option. If you have questions or comments, please leave them below the video.